So far, we've been talking about causality pretty informally. But if we're going to get any quantitative measures of causal effects, we need to know what exactly do we mean by causal effect. So what is the causal effect of, say, Medicaid on cholesterol, or having Medicaid on cholesterol? Well, to answer that, think about one specific unit of analysis, namely you, okay? Now, what you're going to do is write down every single thing that could possibly affect your cholesterol, okay, including whether you have Medicaid or not, okay? Now, we're going to define the causal effect of having Medicaid on your cholesterol as the difference in your outcome, namely your cholesterol level, when you have Medicaid minus when you don't have Medicaid, holding all those other variables constant, holding all those other things that could possibly affect cholesterol the same. That's the causal effect of having Medicaid on your cholesterol. Okay. Now, there's a few important points about this definition. The first is it's a unit causal effect. It's the causal effect for just you. Okay? It's not the causal effect for everyone, not the causal effect for anybody else, just you. The second important point is that the causal effect is a difference, okay? Holding all other variables equal, okay? So what that means is that if we change the values of the other variables and then look at the same difference, we might get a different causal effect. And that's called an interaction. Okay. So for example, the causal effect of having Medicaid may be zero if you have good eating habits, or it may be positive if you have bad eating habits. So, you know, if you have good eating habits, you know, maybe you're just generally healthy, so it doesn't matter whether you have health insurance through Medicaid or not. But if you have bad eating habits, then maybe you're pretty unhealthy, and it actually matters whether you have health insurance through Medicaid or not. Okay, so that's called an interaction effect. The values that of the other variables that we hold fixed may affect the causal effect for you. Okay. Now, both of these points, the fact that it's a causal effect for just you, and the fact that the other variables, the values of them, may interact with your treatment, okay, and cause you to have a different causal effect depending on whether you have good eating habits or bad eating habits, those both say that there's heterogeneity and causal effects, okay? So two people who are not identical might have different causal effects. And moreover, the causal effect for the same person might be different if their other variables change, okay? So basically all I'm saying is that people are different, and so the response to treatment may be different. Giving the same treatment to different people may cause different things to happen. Okay? Now, more abstractly, we envision there being two potential outcomes. The outcome when you have Medicaid and the outcome when you don't have Medicaid. Now, in reality, we will never, ever, ever, ever observe both outcomes. Okay? And that's just because you can't simultaneously be on Medicaid and off Medicaid. So this is sometimes called the fundamental problem of causal inference, okay? And the reason it's a problem is because if we did observe both outcomes, your outcome when you had Medicaid and your outcome when you didn't have Medicaid, then learning causal effects would be easy. You just take the difference, and that's your causal effect. But unfortunately, we don't observe both. That's a big problem, and figuring out how to solve that is what we'll do in the rest of these modules.